Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. We haven't teared down Anker's charger for a while, and today we're gonna tear down a customized charger for League of Legends. It's actually the brand new 65W 3-port charger of PowerPort 3 series. You can check it out in the description. The packaging is dark blue, and there are some selling points and specs information on the back. Open the box, and we can see the black charger and its matte surface. The blue Anker logo is on this side, and the Yaswell is on the other side. It's equipped with 2 USB-C and 1 USB-A, so you can charge 3 devices at the same time. It also adopts folding pins, which is convenient to use. Then let's take a look at those specs information. Mudlist A9521. It supports input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, 1.5 amp. As for the output information, you can pause to take a look. Compared with Apple 61W charger, the size is almost half of it. The size of the charger is 33, 37, 72 mm, so the power density is 0.71 watts cubic centimeter. The weight is around 124 grams. Use ChargerLab Power ZKT002 to test the protocol. USB-A supports Apple 2.4A, Samsung 5V 2A, DCP protocols, and QC23, AFC, FCP, SCP, Vogue-Warp PE2 fast charging protocols. USB-C supports Apple 2.4A, Samsung 5V 2A, DCP protocols, and QC23, AFC, FCP, SCP, PE2, PD3, PPS multiple fast charging protocols. It has 5 fixed PDOs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 3.25A, and 1 PPS of 3.3 to 11V, 5A. The protocols and PDO information of USB C2 is the same as C1. Use the spudger to pry the shell along the gap. We can see the pins are connected to the PCB through a wire. The internal module is also wrapped with heatsink, and the installation plate is placed between the heatsink and components. Remove the heatsink, and the thermal pad is under the insulation plate to enhance heat dissipation. Remove the insulation plate, then we can see a lot of thermoadhesives between front components. ChargerLab found this charger adopts the high-frequency QR flyback architecture. The switching power supply adopts GaN IC and can output fixed voltage. Then, 2 independent secondary step-down circuits can output different voltages. Then, let's start from the input to analyze every single component. The specs of time delay fuse is 250 volts, 3.15 amp. There are 2 combo mode chokes and a safety X2 capacitor on the input PCB. And there are 4 resistors. 2 bridge rectifiers are on the front of the PCB, used to dissipate heat evenly. 3 electrolytic capacitors for high voltage filtering come from Capaxon, 400 volts, 33 microfarad. The master control chip comes from ON Semiconductor NCP1342, which is a highly integrated quasi-resonant flyback controller. It integrates active X2 capacitor discharge feature and has complete protection functions. The primary switch transistor adopts Navitas NV6115, which adopts 5x6mm QFN package. This is a GaN IC, which integrates independent driver and complex logic control circuit. The specs of the GaN FET inside are 170 milliohm 650 volts. It also supports 5 to 15 volts input and 2 MHz switching frequency. Here is the transformer. There is an optocoupler between the primary and secondary circuit used to feedback output voltage. The blue Y capacitor is used for output anti-interference. The synchronous rectifier controller comes from MPS MP6908A. The operating frequency can reach 600 kHz. The synchronous rectifier comes from Hantec HGN070N12S, which adopts DFN 5x6 package, 120 volts 6 milliohm. The solid capacitor for output filtering comes from APAQ 25 volts 680 microfarad. The secondary step-down controller comes from iSmartware SW3518S, used to control step-down output and protocol recognition of USB-C2 and USB-A. It can support multiple protocols and has passed VOLC certification. Those two MOSFETs are controlled by previous chip used for synchronous step-down and outputting the required voltage. The output VBUS MOSFET comes from Ruinchip's RU30D20. Its withstand voltage is 30 volts and packaged by PDFN3333. This is the step-down circuit of USB-C1. We can see step-down inductor, filter capacitor, filter inductor, control chip around the front. Two MOSFETs and an MCU around the back. Here is the USB-C1 controller used for step-down control and protocol identification of USB-C1. Model is iSmartware SW3516H. The solid capacitor for output filtering of USB-C1 also comes from APAQ 25 volts 220 microfarad. Here is the USB-C1. Because of the particular pin inside, the USB-A can support VOLC protocol. Here is the USB-C2. Well, that's all components of this Anker 65 watts 3-port charger. Because of two independent step-down circuits and 3 ports, you can easily charge most of your devices at the same time. It also supports multiple charging protocols, and both USB-C can support maximum output of 65 watts, so you can choose any port. Okay, that's all for today's video. If you're interested in our today's video, you can drop a like and leave your comments. You can also search Anker or click the corners to see the teardown of other Anker chargers. This is Charger Lab, see you in the next video. Bye!